In this video, we'll take an in-depth look at the context of data in ICE. Understanding context can be tricky at first, but it's crucial for working in ICE because it determines how data can be combined. Context is a bit like ownership. It refers to what that data is associated with. For example, this mesh's point position values form a set of data that ICE processes all together. The point positions are associated with the mesh's points, so the point position attribute is in the per-point context of the mesh. Data can be owned by an object like this mesh, or by its components such as its points, polygons, edges, or polynodes. If data is owned by an object, it's a very small data set with only one value in it. For example, a mesh object has one surface area, or one global transform, and so on. However, if data is owned by components, then there can be very many values in the data set. For example, each point in the mesh has its own position, as well as its own normal, and lots of other attributes. Each polygon also has its own position, its own normal, as well as other attributes. Each edge has its own length and other attributes. Each polynode or texture sample point has its own normal, and so on. The context determines how data can be combined. In the object context, with only one value, it's easy to combine any two datasets. For example, you can easily add this gravity force to this wind force, to get the combined force. But what happens when a dataset has multiple values? Well, if only one of the datasets has multiple values, and the other dataset has just one, it's still easy to combine them. You simply combine that single value with each and every other value in the other set. This is already happening in this example. After we combine the gravity and wind forces into a single value, we use that single value to set the particle's force attribute, which is actually a value that's stored on each point of the particle cloud. Let's look at another example. Here, we are adding the local position of each point in the mesh to the global position of this null. The point positions move with the null, although the mesh's global transform is not changing. So, you've seen that it's possible to combine one value with just about anything else. This makes datasets with a single value quite special, which is why they are sometimes called the singleton context. But note that you can only combine singleton with another context in one direction, for example, using the null's position to set the positions of the mesh's points. You can't use the point's positions to control the null's position, because there are many point positions and the null has only one global transform. You would need to first reduce the point position dataset to one value, for example, by taking the average. Context becomes more complicated when both datasets have multiple values. Suppose you wanted to move points along their normals. That involves combining the point position and the point normal attributes. Both datasets belong to points, so there's a natural correspondence between the values. You simply add each point's normal to its own position. It makes no sense to add a point's normal to a different point's position. However, there is no natural way to combine the point positions with the polygon normals. Each point is shared by multiple polygons, and each polygon contains multiple points, so there is no one-to-one correspondence between the two sets. In fact, you can't even connect the data in the ICE tree because the contexts are incompatible. So when datasets belong to the components of an object, you can combine them only if they belong to the same type of component. The same problem happens when data belongs to components on different objects. In general, there's no correspondence between the components of two different geometries. Even if they have the same number of points, there's no obvious way to match them up in pairs. So, there's no way to combine their point positions or any other component data. However, there's one exception. If objects are duplicates of each other, then their topologies are identical. For example, these heads have different shapes, but they share the same topology. In this situation, you can use the Switch Context node to combine their component data. In this example, we've created a simple shape mixer by interpolating between the point positions of Source 1 and Source 2, and setting the point positions of the target mesh. Notice that we needed to use two Switch Context nodes. The first one allows you to combine the data from Source 1 with Source 2. The second allows you to save the result on the target. So to summarize, context refers to the owner of data, such as an object or its points, polygon, edges, or polynodes. You can combine data in the object, or singleton context, with anything else. You can combine data in a component context only with data that's in the same component context. You can't combine component data from different objects, except by using switch contexts when they are duplicates. So that's context in a nutshell. Other videos will show how these concepts work in practice.